In April this year, little Uduvaka Shatai fell off a chair in his grandmother's backyard, hitting his head on a rock. His family rushed him to the nearest clinic in Katutura's informal settlement of Babylon, where they resided at the time. That visit reportedly ended with the nurse assuring them that no harm was done and no damage to his head. A month later, though, Uduva's pain would still not subside, prompting his family to take him for a checkup. But this time, he ended up admitted in the Central State Hospital's intensive care unit. X-rays revealed damage to his skull, and by that time, he also started experiencing breathing difficulties. The accident further left the boy unable to discharge mucus from his nose. According to his grandmother, the doctor confirmed to her that Uduva is brain dead and his lungs have become damaged from the mucus that has accumulated for too long.
The doctors told me that the child's brain is dead, so even if he stops breathing, I'm not going back to that doctor because he already told me that the child is brain dead. They are not God. They are just people like you and I. I believe in God and not doctors.
Looking at her son, Suveka Shatai cannot hold back her tears. She described the pain of seeing her son's condition, noting the accident also resulted in him suffering a stroke.
He was not born like that, but look in the condition that he is. Every hand that will help me, God will help, will bless them in advance. I don't work. Both of my parents don't work. Even the my mother's sister does not work where we are staying now.
A medical procedure allowed for the mucus to be drained from his neck, relieving pressure on his lungs and providing relief. The family has since acquired a hand suction pump, adding they cannot afford a more ideal electric mucus suction pump. They are also appealing for a donation of solar panels and a power generator, as they have since moved back to Ochombinde, a village in the Omaheke region with no electricity. Evelyn Paulus, NBC News, Windhoek.